Here in the South Bronx project is where it all started. DJs would plug their sound systems into the street lamps and jam away in the streets and parks. In those early days, it was a black and Hispanic thing, and it was by all accounts wicked.
Well, basically, we used to do that in the summertime. A lot of people think that we used to give block parties all year round, but that's basically only in the summertime when it gets warm. We used to, you know, get a lamp pole, open it up, and stick the plug in and get the equipment cranked up and start piping. And you would play like early hours, like starting at 2 in the afternoon. Then the word would get out and the crowds would start rolling in by an hour after, and you might have thousands, hundreds. In the wintertime, we took it in the community centers, like Browns River Center. We took it in the high schools and junior high school, like junior high school 123.
In the early day, a DJ used to play a record like from start to finish. Like, you know, which I felt that kind of boring to look at or even to listen to. So what I would do is pick the most climatic part or the strongest part, the funkiest part of the record, and just continuously repeat that part over and over again and sing.
We would play the funk, we would play reggae, calypso, soca, African, any jazz, anything that had a beat and a funky groove. And we used to manipulate it on the turntables back and forth, made different sounds or quick mixing, because at first it was just basically mixing.
But it wasn't until Grandmaster Flash that he says, no, I'm not going to pick the needle up. It's called needle dropping. I'm not going to pick the needle up and drop it on the break where it's supposed to be. That's too unsure for me. I need to go from one turntable to another clean. And what he did is he went to a junkyard in the Bronx and got an old mic switch, an off and on mic switch. He transformed it. Now underline the word transform. He transformed this mic toggle switch into, when he clicked it on the off side, it was really on for this turntable. And when he clicked it on the on side, it was really on for this turntable. This changed the whole way every DJ in the entire world, from Cousin Brucey on, was doing music.
I'll just try to, like, take it apart and put it together again. When I started getting, as they say today, get busy on the turntables, everybody would just stop dancing and just look like as if I was holding class. When my main objective was to get them out there. I mean, it was like it took me hours to figure out the best part of the record. I master it. I make a program out of like 30 or 40 records, and I'm ready to go out there and kill them with the best part of all these 30 or 40 records, and everybody's just standing around. I needed something to get the people off what it was I was doing and into a party mode. From there, that's when MCing. It's now, the standard is now called rapping. Mm-hmm. It was called MCing. And the rapping and the DJing, you know, intertwined together, it worked pretty good. Grandmaster, come faster. Grandmaster, come faster.
Grandmaster, we used to take time between me and my cousin Jazzy J, just dig around for all the old records and just listen to certain break beats. Didn't matter what type of record it is. The whole point is it had a funky groove all together. We pick it up, we worked on it, we try and develop it for somebody, for our rappers.
Yeah, I also used to play commercials. Used to bug the crowd out. They be drawing down, partying, having a good time. Next day I come with a Mountain Dew commercial or Coca-Cola commercial or the Pink Panther theme. And the crowd used to just bug out.
Sampling is definitely an art form. It's something that you can't learn. It's something that has to be in you to know how to manipulate a sample. And that's also being innovative when you sample.
It's taking raw materials, sound and music, and creating something that's new and unique and vibrant in the context of that. You know, kids now for 30 years who've been able to make music, who may not necessarily be musicians, but able to take pieces of musical culture and record collections and digging in the crates and create new musical sounds.
Pimpin', baby. That's right. Big pimpin', spinning cheese. G-G-G-G-G-G. You know I thug them, hug them, love them, leave them, but I don't trust or need them. Take them out the hood, keep them looking good, with diamond cuffs gonna freeze them. First time they fuss, I'm breezing. Talk about what's the reasons. I'm a pimpin' every sense in the word, mama. Better trust and believe them.
And only Digo Double G.
Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg.
Da 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 da. You know I'm hopping with the D-R-E.
Yeah. You know the West Coast is back for all you suckers.
What?
Kanye's production, that's the digital age. That is the perfect representation of the digital age in that sense. There's so much you can do now, you know, and any kid can go down to Sam Ash or Guitar Center and compete with Dr. Dre.
V-Dublé coming from the UK. V-O-O-V's opposition always be. Stronger remix, check it out. It's the V double kick through the speakers like Nike sneakers, popping holes in tweeters, known to push boundaries out to Venus. I got superpowers, or maybe I'm just an alien. What doesn't kill me makes me get stronger like Super Saiyan. So whatever power levels read off me originally is guaranteed to rise and multiply like multiplicity. So why don't we kick the beat, relax and wind and take a seat. I'm double man, that's trouble man, let's get it on, pick up the speed. From the second of pen is the paper, you and I can embark on the caper. We can put foot down in the car outside to go rap in a few million haters. You can take an assault all down around the city, make rockets in every area. And I know I just told you relax, but I don't want your shoes in my custom interior.
Hip-hop is about innovation. You know, like for instance, hip-hop would take the ringtone and make an entirely different beat, rhyme, something out of it. Not just you writing a song or producing music for that market. That's not hip-hop. That's something. That's just you trying to get your money. But where's the innovation? How did you take the ringtone and turn it into something? You know, if you're still using the technology the way the manufacturer intended, then you're not doing hip hop. You have to take the technology the way the manufacturer intended and flip it into a representation of the streets. And then you doing real hip hop in that sense. So those that don't want to do that, great, go get your money, but I'm getting mine too, because you ain't doing what the people want. And when I see you live in the club, I'm busting your ass.